Okay, my first look at this old Fleetwood stereo. The circuit breaker was seized. I freed that up. That allowed power into here. I did notice a resistor right there. See if you can see it right there. That's burnt but still working. And the relative strength of the left and right, it's down on that side. It's good on that side, so I got to figure that out. And plus, the tuning is just... I'm going to try giving it a clean up, see what happens, and go from there. We're getting the stereo light coming on, so that's something. So anyways, oh, and also the turn, the reel-to-reel, I'm seeing quite a serious problem. There's a boss in there that's kind of spot welded or pressed, and it's loose, so that might be a little tricky. Turntable, I just took a preliminary look, and it needs a needle, but I got to go further. So, first report. Okay, I've cleaned up the controls and tuning capacitor, and I'm getting something. One side is weak, as you can hear. I checked AM as well. It's working good enough. I don't hear any hum, but the on-off switch is a little iffy. So the power switch. So I'm going to try and give that a clean. I don't know where you get another one, and they're tough to find. But I got to figure out why this is having issues. The stereo light comes on. Let's see. See if AFC works. It's not working that great, but it's not necessary. I don't want to spend a lot of time on this because it's an older machine. It's not worth anything. It's sentimental to the guy. So anyways, clean the tuner, the variable capacitor, clean the pots, and I'm getting some life. So I'm gonna have to figure out why this unit is quiet on one side. Yeah, the amplifier is here, so I've got carbon copy of each side. I can do A-B comparison. So that's where I'm at this point. Okay, I spotted something. I got both channels, same power now. I don't know who did this, but somebody cut that capacitor right there. It's not shorted, so I hooked it up, and it's working. It's bringing the other channel to life, so I'm going to solder that up. Call it a night for tonight. Ciao. Everything seems okay. Playing a retro song. This is about a 77 or something like that unit. Fleetwood, made in Canada. Playing an old retro song. So, see how it goes. See if it keeps playing. Soldered up that capacitor cut, lead, and cleaned everything up, and we'll see how it goes. So far, so good. That on-off switch, power switch, is a little worrying though. Seems a lot more solid now that I've worked it a bit. Might be okay with that. Anyways, there you go. First night. Not a lot of power, but you know, it's an old machine. This was high end for its day for a cabinet stereo, but it's not a rocker for sure. Not bad, anyways. Does a trick for 77. Better than most. Ciao. Okay, preliminary look at the turntable. This spindle center is seized on there. Hopefully it doesn't make it difficult to get the turntable off, but I don't know if I'm going to bother putting in the automatic spindle or not. I doubt this guy wants to stack his records. The cue works, as you can see. The drive is slipping like a bastard. But you can see if I help it, get it to go to the end, should trigger the mechanism, lifts it up, and of course it stalls because it's dirty, but looks it needs a little adjustment. Landing's not quite correct, but it does go through its cycle. The speed control is also seized, so I got to get this turntable off. But anyways, it's a good start. Looks like it's salvageable. Oh, let me just check and see. Are we getting... Okay, the cartridge is good. There's no needle, but we're getting noise on both sides about even, so probably the cartridge is good. So anyways, step one with the turntable. Ciao. Okay, I managed to get the turntable off. I've lubricated the mechanism. This was jammed. It's still only due to speeds. I got to do more investigation. So I'm just going to clean the drive mechanism. Now you take some alcohol and you clean the shaft. Okay, and then you clean the wheel. Hold it against it. Give it a clean. And then you also clean the inside of the lip of the turntable, you know, with a rag or a Q-tip, alcohol again, and then for the final prep, you push the wheel against the motor, get it down to the bottom, and start sanding it, and just expose fresh new rubber underneath. This one's in pretty good shape. Don't stall the motor, and you don't want to do it too long, but get it good and rough and then put it back together and give it a try. Okay, I've cleaned it. I'm checking the speed. I've got a special wheel that shows 33 and a third, 45. Anyways, as you can see, those lines are pretty stable. So that's a good speed. 45. So next one up. And you can see it's pretty good as well. I mean, this is an old turntable that are not that accurate, but anyways, I still can't get it to go to 78 or 33 at the 12 inch size, because you can go 7 inch 33 record and 12 inch what's on there, but it's still jammed up. It wouldn't move at all. I've lubed it, but there's still an issue, so I'll have to see what's going on. But anyways, that's how far I got. There's no needle, so I can't play anything. But I know the speed's good, and it also does its automatic thing okay. You know, it's set to 7 inch, right? So then it goes at the end, picks up, and it should shut off, which it does. So basically, I just got to figure out the speed lever while it's jammed, get a meter, and this turntable's done. A little bit more lubing, but I think that'll be it. Ciao. Success. I sprayed a lot of WD-40, which is a rust penetration, and loosened up a bunch of stuff. So I managed to get this to work properly after cleaning the drive. So there we go. We're on 33 12 inch record. And as you can see, there's no needle, so it's just going to slide across. I actually adjusted the needle setting, and you'll see it'll just slide across. Basically return and park itself. So that's all functioning properly. The 45 setting for the arm is a little off, so I'm not sure if I can do that. To adjust where this sits, there's a little screw right there. That's what you adjust, just a little bit back and forth, and you'll get it lined up. There's usually not an adjustment for separate 7-inch and 12-inch records, so chances are I'll be playing 12-inch. If he's playing lots of 45s, then maybe I can readjust that and get a happy medium. But anyways, it's doing all its right speeds. There's 33 right there. You see it's doing pretty stable for an old machine. There's 33. There's 45. Right there. And 78, which is right there. You see it's not perfect, but it's pretty darn close. So anyways, she is functioning somewhat. Just need a needle from the looks of it. And I gotta find a clip for the, I'm just gonna slide across because there's no needle. But anyways, I gotta find a C-clip for holding the turntable down. The darn thing broke. So anyways, needle and C-clip, and I think this thing will work. Take care. Well, I got her running, sort of. The motor's pretty iffy. Cleaned these two wheels. This one here, the rewind. And the one down there, I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, there it is. Basically, right there. Well, after about an hour of messing around, I do got it working. The motor's kind of iffy. Everything was stiff and need lubrication. The really biggest issue is this wheel right here. They're both pretty hard. This one's for rewind. This one's for play. And they're both really hard. I reconditioned them by sanding them and stuff. It's got it working anyways, but I don't know if this motor's going to stand up or not. Mechanics are still a little sticky. I tested the tubes. They were all okay. Cleaned the tube sockets. And anyways, there's some retro tunes. This thing hasn't probably played in years. I cleaned it all up. That's the best I can get it going at this point. I'm gonna have to try and source those two wheels though. Good luck on that, but we'll see. But anyways, the next step. Ciao.